Oh man, why is my arm so itchy? Better check WebMD. Why does it always think everything is cancer? Hey y'all, Mandy from My Hectic Life Pets, where we talk about all things pet and pet related. And today we're gonna talk about ringworm. Ringworm, also called tinea, is a communicable disease that can be transferred from pets to people, person to person, as well as from people to pets. I may have commented to one of my employees that I've been here for 3 years and managed to never catch ringworm while tons of other employees had caught it. And sure enough, a few days after I said that, I noticed an extremely itchy spot appeared on my arm, and you guessed it, I jinxed myself. I got ringworm, which is covered up by a Band-Aid right now, because I don't want it spreading to my other pets, or my kid, or my husband, or anyone. Ringworm is actually not a worm at all, but a fungus that tends to present itself as a scaly, round, raised patch on the skin and tends to look normal and healed in the center, giving it an appearance as if there is a worm under the skin coiled up. The most common areas for ringworm to appear on pets are the face, ear tips, tail, and paws. Now, pretty much any mammal can catch ringworm, and it is extremely contagious. The most common pets I've seen getting ringworm are guinea pigs, cats, dogs, and rabbits. I'm pretty sure mine came from guinea pigs. If you're not sure whether or not you have ringworm, some cases are not as obvious as others. Always contact your doctor. They can run tests to confirm it's a fungus or if it is something else causing it. Ringworm can also typically be seen under a black light. Ringworm's very easily treated in people. Topical antifungal creams and sprays such as Lotrimin and Tenactin can be found at almost any drugstore. You'll want to cleanse and apply the topical cream as recommended on the label and keep the area covered until the ringworm has completely cleared, and then continue to treat the area for at least an additional week to ensure that the fungus has been completely eradicated. If you are unsure as to whether or not you have ringworm or you're having a difficult time treating it, doctors can also prescribe antifungal pills to help cure the ringworm. In our pets, ringworm will typically result in hair loss at the infected area and tends to cause a lot of scratching and discomfort. Now, not all hair loss is always the result of ringworm, and a trip to the vet will be able to tell you if it's ringworm or something else. Like, dogs can get mange, and that will also cause hair loss, and then there's many other things. Treatment for pets is still pretty simple, and your vet can prescribe ointment or pills to get rid of the ringworm, but preventing it from spreading can be a little bit more tasking than if it's just a person with it. Keeping your pet's bedding clean and keeping your pet confined until the infection has cleared, as well as using gloves and thoroughly washing your hands while treating your pet or handling any of their belongings, can help aid in the process and keep it from spreading. So really, ringworm is not a horrible deal. I have seen people freak out really badly when they come to find out that a kitten of theirs or a puppy that they brought home or a small animal has ringworm, and they panic, and so many people think it is an actual worm or something really awful. And it's just a fungus that's super treatable, super easy to cure, not usually a big deal. It's pretty much the same fungus that causes things like athlete's foot and jock itch. And I mean, we're used to treating these things. It's really simple. So that's all for today's video. If you found this information useful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, where I post new videos every week. Thanks for watching. Bye.